Greetings and welcome to another edition of The Fan Perspective. I'm your host, Nathan Lyle, and this is my WNBA Draft Day Recap. For those of you who don't know, for the first time in franchise history, the WNBA Draft was held live in prime time. It was on ESPN2 for the first round, and the second and third round on ESPNU. And I will be honest with you, I did not get the chance to watch because I was at work. But here's what I've seen online. With the first pick in the 2013 WNBA draft, the Phoenix Mercury selected Brittany Griner.
Stop the fucking presses.
I think if the Phoenix Mercury hadn't selected her, I would literally have died of shock. She is the total package. She's got height, athleticism, she's got a great range. She plays some good defense as well, and she's going to make a hell of a compliment to Diana Taurasi. It's basically like putting Michael Jordan and Wilt Chamberlain on the same team. Unfucking stoppable. Because back in college, she was getting quadruple teamed every single time she touched the ball. If they try to do that in the WNBA, Diana Taurasi is going to kill them. Not to mention the development of Sammy P. She had a great debut season last year. Dwana Bonner, she's been there for a few years, but she's really starting to make a name for herself. The second pick, the Chicago Sky selected Elena Delladonna. Let's be honest, the Chicago Sky, they were a 50-50 team last year, and I think no matter who they picked, it's going to make them better. Unless she completely fizzles out, which I do not expect, because from what little of her that I have seen, she appears to have quite some talent. She's listed as a 6'5 guard slash forward, so we'll see what she lines up once she actually gets into the rotation. But either way, I feel she's definitely going to be one of those players that comes in and has an immediate impact. The third overall pick was the Tulsa Shock, who selected Skylar Diggins, who was listed as 5'9 and guard. And yeah, she's definitely going to be one of those people who I think it's, well, she's playing for Tulsa. So if she struggles a little bit to start, don't be surprised. But then again, I think longevity-wise, she's definitely one hell of a pick. This is the kind of player that you can really build upon. I think she'll only get better with time. And with all of these picks, honestly, only time will tell. Because like I said, Brittany Griner, off the top of my head, she just seems like one of the best prospects the WNBA has ever seen. But then again, you know, from the get-go, nobody thought Becky Hammon would do anything. She was undrafted, she unscouted, she had to fight her way from the bottom, and now she's known as one of the best. So I really can't predict the future for you. I don't know how well any of this will turn out. But I do know this, I'm going to run down the rest of the people who were chosen in the first round, and I'm going to list all of them, as well as the second and third rounders in the bottom down here, for those of you who didn't see it. And I am going to start, I have started working on power rankings. Those aren't going to be up till for at least a week, because I'm also working on NBA stuff, not to mention, I've got a few major projects. I've only got a couple weeks left in school, a lot of major grades left, and I want to be getting A's in all my classes. But I'm doing what I can for you. So look down in the description below to see a complete list of everyone that was drafted and in what order. And all I can say is keep tuning in, because, especially once summer gets here and the season actually starts going full swing, I will start doing more and more coverage of WNBA action. And until then, this is Nathan Lyle. This has been The Fan Perspective. I look forward to having a really great season with you.